Welcome back to Let's Play Shadowrun. Now, our first priority should be finding a place to take a nap. So I think it's over this way. Is there a... Yep, knew it. You can tell when people are going to jump at you because those windows, for example, are open. Or you can see a little silhouette in a trash can for those wacky snipers that like to hang out in dumpsters for some reason. Where is it? Yeah. Where's that coming from? Oh, there. Gotcha. Alright. This looks like a club. No, this is where I want to go, actually. Hotel manager. Darn music! Them Shadowrunner types blasting away with that racket at all hours. It's no wonder guests don't stay long. You looking for a room? There's only one left. First room on the left. 50 New Yen. You want it? Yes, we do. 50 New Yen is a it's a little silly, but we can make that up pretty easily by chopping through guys. And we will... I don't want to shoot the door. We can make that up, you know, from the arena and such. But having a place to sleep is good. Because we can save and spend karma. And we don't have to travel all the way back to Old Town, for example. And pump computers. Because we're going to do a little hacking in a bit. Now that we have our computer all fixed. Our data jack is functional. So let's go down to the docks now. Let's go see what's going on down there. Ah! Ambushed. Again. So you remember way back in the beginning of the game, when we rolled out of bed? I mean, that morgue slab. And there was a piece of paper in there. It said warehouse number 5. Maybe there's something important down in warehouse number 5. Let's go check it out. I wonder what it is. Jeez! In the bushes again. In the building. God, crossfire everywhere. Alright. This is gonna help with some of the getting shot all the time. Because if we play our cards right, we should be able to get our magic pretty soon. And I'm not talking about throwing fireballs, because there is a damage spell, powerball spell, but it's not good. The guns that you have are usually better. The real strength of magic is the heal spell, and lo and behold, it's the first thing we get access to. Oh, and an orc in pink. Oh, and a mage. Rune mages. It's probably tougher. Ah, karma point. Very nice. 50 New Yen. That's just made back the cost of the hotel. Right off the bat. Let's talk to this fat guy down here by the docks. What do you know? No, don't walk into the frickin' barrel.
Well, you be looking for a ship. The docks are the right place. Longhorn Jack, they called me. Finest taxi boat driver in this fine city. Yar. I am a pirate. Except for the spirits, they be mostly deserted now. People came shooting and taking people away a while back. Some rough types now guard the warehouses.
Spooky. Matrix systems? Anything? No. It is in Seattle, you putz. Oh, it's okay, we don't need him yet. He can be useless. Ah, walked right into that one. Let's take out this guy. He's got low hit points. Now we can focus on the orc.
A massive orc!
He's not just big and angry, he's massive! It's an interesting progression. Ferocious to massive. You'd think that, like, the two are not necessarily exclusive. Oh! mage is casting spells. Now we're really getting into dangerous territory. It's almost like the game is advancing. Your magic is no match for me and my shotgun. Now there was a door back there, wasn't there? Are there enemies? Yeah, there are enemies. Gotcha. Who else? Who else is... Oh. Another one of those trench coat hitmen. Gotcha. 50 new yen. Alright. Let's see what's going on in here. Computers. Can't use that one. Can't use those. Can use this one. Let's try. Save state. With any luck, we will get our first look at the hacking system. Matrix Systems Incorporated, Cyberspace Solutions. Oh, we have found Matrix Systems. Okay. So, we are in the Matrix now. I know, it looks a little dull. But this is us, our avatar in the Matrix virtual reality. That top bar is our health, and that bottom bar is sort of like a RAM, how much information we can store. Okay, so there's an ice here, which is a kind of a security countermeasure. It'll hurt you if you walk into it, but we can fight it with our computer skill. It's a little bit like Minesweeper. So, what I'm doing right now is attacking those ice... Okay, we got some data. Get rid of them. Where am I going now? Let's jack out. Matrix account. Got a bunch of numbers, and 2,000 new yen! And there was a mage waiting for us. You don't think he could have killed us while we were in the Matrix? Stranding us in the virtual reality forever? That would have been a better strategy. Oh well. There's that file. Let's take a look at it. Anti-AI program finally complete. Courier is to deliver it to Pushkin. Cortex bomb will be implanted to protect the data. All other copies destroyed. Rights of. Well, the picture's coming together about who we are and what we're doing. We've got something pretty important, some kind of really important program here in our brain. And the courier, the Cortex bomb, sort of like a failsafe. Neat. Well, let's see. Let's go explore a little more about this area. We've got a little... actually, we might want to go back to the hotel for one moment. Those ICs didn't do too much of a number on me, but you do lose health every time that you attack in the Matrix, and you don't actually hit anything. Which is a little frustrating, because you don't always know where the ices are. So... process of elimination. Or, you can just kind of boldly charge through, which is essentially what I did. Just go in a straight line and take out anything that's there. Not a bad plan, ultimately. Oh no! Stop hiding in the grass. You think that Jake would kind of wise up to this after a while. See, another one. This is just getting silly. These guys don't really have much of an imagination, do they? Another? Stop. I just want to go to bed for a minute. Stop shooting me. Alright. Ugh. It's kind of like a chore now, isn't it? first it was actually like putting the fear of death in me, and now it's sort of, God, don't make me kill another assassin. How blasé, how boring. Ugh. Come on, guys. How many assassins can we cram into this city? Oh. Jeez. Friggin'. I'm out of witty comments. Just give me the keys. Yeah. Damn kids, get off my lawn, yada. Get in that bed. Sleep it off, Jake. Man up. Skills, computer 5. Save. Okay. Once more onto the breach, dear fellows. Do I have a sign on my back or something? Is there like a giant neon sign that I'm missing that just says, shoot me, please? In fairness, this is a little bit like the tabletop experience. Although, you're usually a little more paranoid and less... I don't know. I guess you could get paranoid about where you're gonna get jumped. Especially when you're low on health. I've said it before, but I really do encourage you all to go check out the tabletop game if you've never played it before. It's been suggested that I do a little LP of the Genesis version of this game, which has nothing to do with it, except for the fact that it's in the same universe. It's actually a much more faithful adaptation of the Shadowrun rules, in that it actually has more than just 3 stats. The skills are much more diverse. It fits the fluff a lot more, a lot better. Who's shooting? Oh, there he is. Yeah. There's even a little more of the RPG element to it, in that you have to pick an archetype and develop your character accordingly. It'll give you certain inherent bonuses and so forth. Like, if you're a street samurai, you're a really tough guy, you have all these combat skills right off the bat, you have hand razors. If you're a decker, you get a cyber deck and then a hacking skill right off the bat. Locked, eh? Have a key for that? Warehouse key or something? Door key. Wrong kind of key. Oh yeah, you can also be a gator shaman in that version, which I think is pretty great. Because who doesn't want to be a alligator-worshipping shaman? Okay, what's in here? Whoa! Go and do not return until you have the 3 items from my followers. One of the earth, one of a creature, one of a man. That looks like a dog, and it is a dog spirit. Now, we have the dog collar. Well, that is one of his followers, we would assume. And that paperweight is, I think that's the man item. Or of Earth. It would make sense if it was really with the Earth. Whoa! And there's one more item. What is it? I remember now. We cannot get it until we actually do another job. And it involves those gangers who jumped us as soon as we came off the downtown train station. The Rustos. not a particularly good gang name. It sounds like one of the gangs in the Warriors, doesn't it? The Rustalettos. Like the Baseball Furies. That's a great movie. I haven't actually played the game from Rockstar, but I can't imagine it's actually as good as the film. Of course. Well, maybe it is. Anyone out there know? I'd love to hear it. If I can hook my PS2 up to my computer somehow, I'd love to do an LP of it. If for nothing else than the novelty of it being a Warriors game. Yeah, if you guys do have any game suggestions for me, please let me know. I'd love to hear them. I will try my best. Loyal Citizen. In this universe? Yeah, right. Jake, it's me, Sassy. I've been waiting for you. Come closer. No. I'm sorry we ever broke up, Jake. Don't leave me. No. No, I don't believe you. I think that... It's a trap! It's an octopus! Whoa! And it throws... puddles of water? Snakes? Water spirits? I don't know what those are. I'm just gonna shoot the octopus until it dies. Am I even hitting it? I guess I am. I'm just not doing much damage to it. Why is an octopus trying to kill us? Can anyone answer that? And why would it impersonate our girlfriend? That's really weird. That's a really prescient octopus, isn't it? Was it her pet? Did Jake Armitage keep an octopus in his apartment or something like that? Maybe it has a goal, some sort of freaky agenda. Like, maybe that's her new boyfriend. 2000 New Yen. A pool of ink. It's black ink. Yes. But it made that little sparkly sound, which means that it's a plot item of some kind. And we cannot pick it up. But I have a pretty good idea of how we can. Remember that Talismonger shop? Yeah, the bottle's on sale. I think we need to use that black bottle. Well, either way, we cleared out the docks. Got some karma out of it. Got a little cash. This guy's not even shooting us. Is there an orc? It's a mage, maybe? No, it's another one of those guys. How could he see us and the other guy couldn't? Game, I am disappointed. Okay. Now what? Gotta get that last symbol of dog's favor. Go away. Go away. That we need to clear out the Rustalettos area. So, let's see. We've got 9 karma. 9,000 New Yen. That's pretty nice. Ah. So I guess let's look for that hideout. Graveyard. And more assassins. Where? Ooh, there you are. Another creepy gate. Whoa, whoa! What's going on here? This guy throwing Molotovs at us. A gang member. And now he's coming at us with a spiky club. Bugger off! Why you do this? Jeez! This guy's really tough. This is not good. Let's see if I can't take care of that people. Alright. Nope, stop. Sorry about that. Those buttons are awfully close. Let's get the heck out of here and go back to the hotel. And this video is actually carrying on a little bit, so, probably a good place to stop. I'll get to the hotel at least. Let's stop and pop these guys anyway. They probably won't kill me. Famous last words. Knew it. Right next to him. More karma, though. You have, like, 11 now? I'm okay with that. Let's see. Right by the door. Okay. Home, sweet home. Frankly, this hotel is pretty nice. I mean, we have a potted plant. If you know the fluff, you know, I'm sure you're familiar with coffin motels, which are essentially coffins. You know, they're about as big as a coffin, and there's really nothing there in terms of decoration. Oh, we've maxed out computers. We cannot increase it any further. That's pretty sweet. Okay. So, next time, we will take on the Rust Stiletto's hideout.